Search and destroy up next. We've got to sink 100% of battleships, so two battleships while trying to dodge the torpedoes. So I've just gone for a really fast ship to try and chase down the battleships. And it's not got particularly good guns or accuracy, but if I can get there quick enough, then it should be pretty good. I could boost the accuracy up and only take two battleships. So at 10,000 meters, 6.9 or 4.6. So 2.3 works out exactly the same. So I'd rather have the extra hit points, or whatever you want to call it, on the field or in the sea, because the accuracy works out the same for cost. So I'd rather an extra ship. With me primarily chasing down, I probably could have done this completely different and had all front facing turrets rather than sticking a couple of not so great turrets at the back. So if this doesn't go too well, that's what I'll do on the next design. Just put some bigger guns up front instead. So luckily our destroyers are faster than our battleships, so I can use them to screen. Looks like they are that direction. waste of torpedoes. Well, it appears as if we don't have to sink all three, we only have to sink two. Oh, the other one is a battle cruiser. Right, okay. Did I read that wrong? I must have read that wrong, I thought it was three. There's only two. The picture confused me. Right, yeah, that was easy. Here we have destroyer full fleet, where we have to destroy 50% of the fleet. It makes me chuckle. I need to keep alive 50% of allies. So, I need to keep alive three of them, so I can afford to lose two. Now, I've gone for a bit of a weird design, because I've got 12 inch and 14 inch, just because I can't fit 14 on there, and I don't want to drop the caliber of all the other guns, so I've just got one gun that's using the wrong ammo basically. I've put a lot of deck armour on. I'm going in quite heavily armoured, apart from on these three. Could, if I wanted, put the crew training up, but again, like with the last one, all it's doing is reducing the amount of shots that I take, because I've got less battleships, and increasing the accuracy, so not really much point in doing that. I've got as much critical resistance as I can, and I've gone for a little bit of anti-tor just to, in case I do get hit by a couple. I've kept the armor to the minimum, the armor quality. That's mainly just because it costs so much. If I wanted, I could increase this and then strip some off, but it doesn't really seem worth it. So we've got 70% there. So it adds 30% on, but we're going to have to drop a battleship for the sake of 30%. So a battleship is worth 20%. You know, or 25% if you want to say a quarter more battleships. So it just doesn't seem worth it. And obviously I'll end up with a load of weights that I need to invest into something. Probably more armor. Just seems counterintuitive to drop a battleship. So off we go. I've just noticed, and I don't know whether it's one of the ammunitions that I'm using, but plunging fire, the penetration on the plunging fire is nothing compared to what it used to be. It's basically the same penetration that it is on the belt at max range, which seems a bit odd. I swear it used to be a lot more than that. Maybe I'm wrong. Well, that was easy. We're on to Rise of the Heavy Cruiser now. We've got to sink 3 armoured cruisers and 2 destroyers. Now, I've gone for a design that I wouldn't normally do, which is no manoeuvrability. Normally with armoured cruisers I like to put them up to max manoeuvrability, but I thought I'd try and use it as a gunboat. Not quite sure how this is going to go, if I'm honest. I've put a few torpedoes on just to, I don't know, maybe get a lucky hit. I'm not too hopeful about that. The main reason I put them there is just to balance the ship out, but you never know. I've got quite a nice amount of armour as well, just to protect against all the small arms fire. Probably didn't need 12 inches of main belt, but no harm. Almost 32 knot speed. Yep, I'm quite happy with that. That's some pretty long range torpedo action going on. I think I might regret not taking all the maneuverability stuff. That's a lot of torpedoes. Well, that was a slaughter. Dreadnought versus modern cruisers next. I've gone for a bit of a weird design. I've stuck three torpedo tubes down here. But that was just to balance the ship out. It was a bit of a nightmare trying to balance it out. So I've got a turret hanging over the main belt, which is not good. I have got 6 inches of aft belt armor though, so it might be okay. So it's definitely a weird design. But I've got 4 16-inch guns here, times 3. And I've got 4 battleships, so That's a lot of guns. If I wanted, I could put this up to around about there. So that'll give me 10 kilometers, 6.4, or 10 kilometers, 4.9. So it's only 1.5 more. And I lose a ship, so I'd rather have 20% or 25% more ships, or 33% if it's 3 to 4, than just have 1.5 more on the accuracy. So max the beam out to get maximum accuracy and minimum draft for maximum accuracy. Got quite decent flash fire chance. And torpedo resistance isn't too bad in it. So yeah, pretty well armoured, pretty well armed. Some torpedoes. Pretty decent critical resistance. The only thing that it lacks is speed, but hopefully I won't need it, and they'll just sail straight at me. You could just build a much more expensive ship, but I don't see the point in expensive ships if you can get cheap ships that are really accurate with big caliber guns. Well, they're sailing towards me, so that's good. That is some pretty long torpedo range. I don't like that. I'm hoping that I might be able to spot the torpedoes in time, but I've got a really unmaneuverable ship, despite it saying 564, that doesn't mean anything. The turning circle in this game is wrong. If you're looking at a stat to see what your turning circle is, you should look at your turning rate. not your minimum turning circle. Well, even though I preemptively dodged it, it only just missed. That was a shame. I wasn't prepared for a torpedo from the battlecruiser. Pop that up. Oh, he's got a lot of torpedoes. Well, it was a shame that I cocked up the torpedo dodge on this ship, but it's all good. Got modern battleship next. I need to sink 70% of enemies. So 3, 5, 8, 10, 12, 13. Nine or ten, so we need to sink 10 of them. So we don't need to sink the battleships if we can destroy the others. So we've got 4x16-inch guns. It's my favourite setup, really, for these expensive battleships. And then just got some 6 inches and some torpedo tubes to balance the ship out. 33 knots, pretty fast. Best accuracy. Some pretty decent crew. And some pretty decent main deck and main belt with adequate fore belt and aft belt. So yeah, we've got two on. I think we'll be okay. Thank you. Well, he hasn't got torpedoes. What's he playing at? They've got 12.4. And has the battleship got any? 8.5. Where did that come from? Inch ball belt penetration. Ouch. Well, it's cooked off my entire 16-inch ammo, even though two of my things are right at the back. Oh well. What can you do? Well, it wasn't plain sailing, but it wasn't too difficult either. Well, we're on to numbers don't matter. Unfortunately, the start of the recording corrupted, so I've already completed this mission. But my god, was it slow and painful. So, I'll show you the ship, and I'll show you the very end of the battle. But you don't want to watch the rest, it was just agonising. So, I've cut out 90% of the battle, well, more than that, probably 99% of the battle. Because it was just them running away for the entire bloody thing. Me chasing them down with a 0.7 knot speed advantage, it was agonising. So this is what I took, loads of guns and some pretty decent armour, but my speed was just not quite good enough because he was 25.7. I mean, it was good enough to win, but Jesus, I wish I'd have taken more. So yeah, that's this battle. Numbers don't matter. Well, I've had to edit this one down because all he's done is run away, and my god, has it taken a long time to chase him down. He's even though he's had his engines knocked out, his hull form's obviously so good that he hasn't even barely slowed down. He's just been cruising along, carving through the sea. So yeah, this has taken an age. But we are slowly getting there. We've run out of ammo with quite a few of our ships. I had to use it all up just to slow him down. So I'm just going to finish it off with a little ramp. So there we go, that took far too long for me to actually show that episode. I do apologise, but you did not want to see that. Oh dear. Right, well, on to the next one. There can only be one. To be honest with you, I can't even remember this mission. I don't know if it's new, or if it was so easy that it just wasn't memorable. But we're doing it. Battleship duel. Yeah, I've just got 20-inch guns. Lots of them. Maximum accuracy. Couldn't quite get maximum on this. I suppose I could have done if I reduced the weight. I've got barbettes and citadels maxed out. I haven't got any maneuverability stuff because I assume this is all going to take place at incredibly long range. Yeah, I'm only taking Gen 1 radar. I don't think it's worth the cost to take higher. It's too heavy, too expensive. The only thing that I'm not too fond of here is 8. Main deck. I just don't think it's going to be quite high enough. But it all depends on how good the enemy ship is. It might be a crapshoot, in which case 8 will be perfectly acceptable. Okay, so I'm gonna head directly at him, just so I can get the ricochet chance. Well, he's landed quite a few big hits on me. He's definitely done more damage than I have. Be interesting to see what crew he's got and if he's got the best radar. Because that's where I'm lacking accuracy. Really not done too great at ricocheting, just 2 so far, 1 blocked. I might be better off using HG, see if I get more ricochets. Yeah, I got a ricochet down, so I'm gonna switch over to HG, see if I get any joy with that. Okay, let's have a look. He has got Gen 3 radar, 45. Then we got a regular cruiser. I've got season. Got 15%, I've got 23%. I've landed 15%, he's landed 12, but I've ricocheted 7, he's only ricocheted 4, well 5 now. It was a very, very even fight. Definitely not one-sided. because I don't seem to be ricocheting much, I might just bring all of my guns to bear. My HG rounds are not performing very well, I don't think. Why, but my guns have got worse accuracy than his. Oh no, still slightly higher. Well, it's been an incredibly close fight. I'm wondering whether I'm not getting any damage when I'm hitting sections that are already destroyed. So maybe switching back to HG isn't a bad idea. wonder what his armor is. Yeah. He's well armored. Well, the AI has built a decent ship. Ah, he's run out of 18 inches. I was wondering why suddenly he'd stop doing damage. So I may as well chase him down. Well, say chase him down. 4 knots. I'm going 15 at the moment. He's actually going faster than I am. That's not good. That's not good at all. This could go on for a while. Well, almost there. 2% more, but it's right at the front, underneath. So I think my only hope really is getting some fire damage. Oh, nice. That was incredibly close. That was incredibly close. Sink the cruiser killer next. We've built a very similar design to the last ship, only this time I've put more armor on the main deck, and I've gone for quad turrets instead of triple. That can't shoot forward. Why is that unable to shoot forward? Come on. That makes no sense. It's got... That makes no sense. I don't get that. Why can't it shoot forward? Well, I think what I'm going to do is start the battle see if it can actually shoot forward, because there's no reason why it shouldn't be able to. So we're going to see if it does, and it's just a visual glitch. Well, it's not a visual glitch, it's not shooting forward. That's very strange. It's like there's an invisible block. I don't get that at all. Thank you. Well, it was a very strange visual, well, not visual, but a very strange structural block going on there with them guns, but I don't think it's going to make any difference. But yeah, very, very peculiar. Very peculiar indeed. Okay, so we're on to heavy duty now, and all we have to do is sink a battleship. There's only one, so I'm going for a very similar design to the last two, only a complete glass cannon and a ridiculously slow ship. So I've stripped literally everything off it. No armor, no bulkheads, no speed, no crew, no anything. Just so I can get six battleships with eight forward facing 20 inch guns. And 53 on the training, Gen 3 radar, and coincidence 5. So it's going to be a lot of shots. I'm guessing it's not going to take very long. You know what, I think I'm just going to turn everyone around, face that way. Yep. Numbers always wins. Look at that. I could have designed like one ship and made it proper. Or properly, I should say. But instead, you just design dirt cheap ships with really high accuracy. The glass cannon approach.